national news. Puerto Rico faces weeks without electricity after Hurricane Maria hits. From ABC News by Danica Cotto, Associated Press, September 22, 2017. After Hurricane Maria hit Puerto Rico, the power went out on the entire island and will stay for weeks, possibly months. A lot of people have left or are in the process of leaving the island because they say that they don't have any items that are able to be used without power. The island is in a state of crisis because they cannot afford to get the power back anytime soon, as they will remain powerless until further notice. The most surprising thing I found out while reading this article about Puerto Rico losing power was that the power territory is in a $73 billion crisis and has left agencies like the State Power Company broke. After reading the article, I wonder when the island will get power back, and more importantly, if the island will get power back. I think that in a few weeks, the island will regain power thanks to celebrity donations and fundraisers. Political news. Senator Gardner says it's unacceptable to allow North Korea to maintain a nuclear program. On CBS News by Emily Tillett, 9-24-17. In this article about nuclear bombs in North Korea, Senator Gardner talks about it being unacceptable for North Korea to be testing nuclear bombs. He also talks about our number one goal being peaceful denuclearization and that we are still unfortunately a long way away from that. He addresses the issue of China not doing a good job of taking responsibility to work with the denuclearization of North Korea, saying that they are responsible for 90% of the economy there and that it is time they started doing more. I did not realize that North Korea was testing nuclear bombs. That is a very dangerous thing for us and them, for it puts us in danger and them in danger for being targeted. I also did not know that one of the main goals of the U.S. was peaceful denuclearization. I'm curious as to if we will ever achieve peaceful denuclearization, and if so, will the world be peaceful? Will the world truly ever be completely and 100% peaceful? Unfortunately, I do not think so. There is no good without evil, because if there is no evil, then there is no good to compare it to. For the news article of my choice, I chose the article, Could the World Come to an End? On Fox News by Billy Hallowell, 9-22-17. The main idea of this article is about how a Christian leader, Harold Camping, made international headlines twice for pretending that the world would end, and obviously being wrong both times. It tells about how he thought that Jesus would return to Earth, and he believes the rapture, the belief that Christians will be taken up before cataclysmic end times events kick into high gear, or the end itself will unfold. The article also tells a lot about how the Bible has stated multiple times that no one will know for sure when Jesus will come back to Earth, so there is no way of knowing. I learned that no one on the planet knows when Jesus is going to come back to Earth, so we all just have to live life to its fullest and not worry about it because no one knows for sure when it will actually happen. I would normally ask the question, will the world actually come to an end? It is now past the time that the world was said to have ended. I know that the prediction was wrong and I feel bad for those who got worked up over it, but I can now feel relieved knowing that the world is not actually ending.